Today, Henry met
a caterpillar.
Ten, nine, eight, seven.
Hello, caterpillar.
Hello, Henry.
Six.
How are you today, caterpillar?
Five, four.
I'm great, thanks, Henry.
It's another lovely day in the back garden, surrounded by all these delicious, tasty leaves.
Caterpillar?
Yes, Henry?
Why are you counting backwards?
I'm playing hide-and-seek with my brother, and it's my turn to seek. He doesn't stand a chance. Three, two, one, coming. Ready or not? Maybe he's inside this flower.
Sorry, just collecting some nectar.
Maybe he's under this stone.
Oh, hello, caterpillar. I'm just going this way.
Yum, yum,
maybe
yum.
He's behind this beetle.
Nothing behind me, I'm afraid.
I can't see him anywhere. Maybe finding him's going to be harder than I thought.
I love playing hide and seek, caterpillar. Maybe I could help you look.
Thanks for the offer, Henry, but you're much, much too big. You might accidentally squash something. Oh, if only you were the size of an insect, Henry. Then you'd be able to help.
That gives me a great idea, caterpillar. I could shrink down to the size of an insect, and we can find your brother together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, caterpillar, let's start looking. Hello, spider.
Hello, Henry. Hello, caterpillar. Have you come to join me for a spot of exercise this morning?
Oh, that sounds lovely, spider. But we're actually in the middle of playing hide-and-seek. We're looking for Caterpillar's brother. Have you seen him?
He's green, like me. He has lots of legs, like me. Oh, and he loves eating leaves.
Hom, hom, yum, yum. Like me.
I haven't, I'm afraid, but there are some really good hiding places over there.
Hom,
great.
Hom,
thanks, spider.
Thanks.
Oh, and there's some great hiding places over there, too.
Oh.
And down there. And up there, round there, oh, and don't forget in there. Come to think of it, he could be hiding anywhere.
Oh no, Henry, Spider's right. My brother could be anywhere. What are we gonna do?
Don't worry, Caterpillar. I'm sure we'll find him if we just keep looking. All we need to do is look for something that's green, has lots of legs, and loves eating leaves. Look, there's something green. Aww. It's just a green fly.
Hello, Henry.
Look, there's something with lots and lots and lots of legs. Aw, that's just a millipede.
Hello, Henry.
Wait, I can hear something munching leaves. Aw, it's just a snail.
Hello, Henry.
We're not having much luck playing hide and seek today, are we, Henry? And to make matters worse, it looks like it's gonna rain.
Don't worry, Caterpillar. A little bit of rain never hurt anyone. Unless you're the size of an insect. Run away!
Mummy!
Caterpillar, where have you been all day?
We've been playing hide and seek, and we're looking for...
your brother.
That's right, but we can't find him anywhere, Butterfly.
You're closer than you think, Henry. In fact, he's right above your head.
Wow! He's turned into a chrysalis, Henry! No wonder we couldn't find him!
What's a chrysalis?
Well, Henry, a chrysalis is the final stage before a caterpillar turns into a grown-up. They eat and eat and eat, go asleep, and a few days later, they emerge a beautiful butterfly.
Wow! That's amazing! Caterpillar! That means you're going to be a butterfly soon.
I know, Henry. I can't wait.
Well, you best get to bed, because the sooner you fall asleep, the sooner you'll be a butterfly.
Yay!
Today Henry met a caterpillar. He laughed along with everyone. Today Henry met a caterpillar. He made lots of friends and had so much fun.
That's my mum calling me caterpillar, or should I say butterfly. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for helping me find my brother.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a
teapot!
Hello, teapot.
Ah, hello, Henry, my little sugar lump.
How are you today, Teapot?
Oh, I'm wonderful, thanks, Henry. I love being at the car boot sale. You never know what you might come across next. What are you looking for today?
I'm looking for a lovely tea set for my mum, because she's having a tea party today.
Oh, me and my tea set used to throw the most fabulous tea parties. We would have biscuits, sandwiches and tea cakes with jam and cream.
In that case, would you like to join us?
Oh, I'd love to, Henry, but I'm all on my lonesome now, and a teapot isn't much use without their tea set.
Oh dear, what happened to the rest of your tea set, Teapot?
They were all taken to an antique shop, Henry. You see, antiques like me are very valuable, but I was left behind by accident.
That's terrible news, Teapot. But, what's an antique?
An antique is something that is over 100 years old. It's usually collectible and very, very rare. Oh, if only there was an antique dealer around, then we could go to the shop and find my missing tea set.
That gives me a great idea, Teapot. I could become an antique dealer and we can find the rest of your tea set and have a tea party together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
OK, Teapot, first things first. What exactly is a tea set?
Oh, well, Henry, a tea set has everything we need for the perfect tea party. There's cups and saucers for our tea, a little jug for our milk, a bowl for the sugar, and for the cake and bickies, there's a tea tray.
Oh, did someone say tea tray?
Tea tray, there you are. It's so good to see you again.
Oh, hello. Who are you again?
It's me, Teapot, from the tea set. Don't you remember?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. How forgetful of me.
Hello, tea tray. We're having a tea party today, but we're still looking for the rest of the tea set. Have you seen them?
The rest of the tea set? Yes, yes. I put them in a super special place so they won't get lost.
Ah, that's great news. Where did you put them?
Put what?
The tea set.
Oh, right, yes, it's the tea set. No, I can't remember. But I'm sure they're in the antique shop somewhere.
Bless my tea bags, Henry. The antique shop is a lot bigger than I thought it would be. It's going to take us all day to find them.
Don't worry, Teapot. I'm sure if we ask some of the other antiques for help, we'll find them in no time. Hello, suit of armour. Have you seen an antique tea set around?
King Henry, my humblest apologies, Your Majesty, for I must confess I have not.
Hello, Clock. Have you seen an antique tea set around here at all?
Sorry, Henry. I haven't had time to look for the tea set, I'm afraid.
Hello, Plastic Skeleton. Have you seen a tea set in the antique shop today?
I haven't, I'm afraid, Henry. I've been having enough trouble keeping my head on my shoulders.
We've looked everywhere and no one has seen my missing tea set.
Oh, don't worry, Teapot. I'm sure things will start looking up soon.
Looking up? That's it. We need to look up.
Hello, Henry.
Oh, Henry, they're up ever so high. I think we might need some help to get them down in one piece.
Did someone say they needed help? Not again.
The tea set is going to get smashed to pieces, Henry. What are we going to do?
Don't worry, Teapot. I think I have an idea.
Thanks, Henry!
Well done, Henry. You found the tea set and managed to catch them all safely.
Thanks, Teapot. Now, who's ready for a tea party?
The day Henry met a teapot, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a teapot, he made lots of friends and had so much fun.
Henry!
That's my mum calling me, Teapot. We best be off. We don't want to be late for my mum's tea party.
You're right, Henry. And thanks ever so much for helping me find the rest of my tea set.
You're welcome, Teapot. Next up, my mum's tea party.
Yay!
The day Henry met!
Running shoes!
Shoes.
Hi, Henry.
Hiya, Henry.
How are you today, Running Shoes?
We feel amazing, don't we, Running Shoe?
That's right, Running Shoe. We do, because we love living in the sports shop.
We get to
run on the running machine.
Lift some weights.
Or do keepy-uppies.
Anytime we want.
Do you two always finish each other's sentences?
We certainly do. We love
finishing each other's sentences.
Because
we
are
best friends
forever.
Yay!
Wow. With all that exercise, you two must be so fit. I bet you've entered lots of fun sporting events together.
Well, Henry, sadly we've never actually entered a sports event before, have we, Running Shoe?
We haven't, Running Shoe. In fact, we've never even left this shop.
Really? Well, why don't you hold your own sports event here? I'm sure you'd have lots of fun, and you might even win a medal.
That would be amazing, Henry, but it wouldn't be much fun without someone to compete against.
Oh, if only there was an athlete around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Running Shoes. I could become an athlete, and we could enter the sports event together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, Henry, first things first. We need to do some warm-ups.
Warm-ups? What are they, Running Shoe?
Warming up before you exercise gets the blood pumping to all your muscles
and keeps you nice and flexible so you're less likely to hurt yourself.
First, we jog on the spot.
Like this?
That's it, Henry.
Next, we stretch side to side.
And last but not least,
our favourite bit,
shake it all out!
Attention all competitors, the 100 metres is about to begin. On your marks.
Ready, Running Shoes.
Ready, Henry.
Get set, go!
Hello, finish line.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, high jump.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, shot put.
Hello, Henry.
Phew. Okay, Running Shoes. We all ran the fastest. We all jumped the highest. And we all threw the furthest.
That means it will come down to the last event, Henry.
The hurdles.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, hurdles.
Good luck, Henry.
Good luck, Running Shoes. May the best boy or shoe win.
On your marks. Get set. Go!
You're doing great, Henry.
So are you, Running Shoe.
Thanks, Running Shoe.
Here we
go.
Phew. I'm in the lead, and the finish line is just up ahead.
Come on, Henry. You're almost here.
Whoa. Oh, no.
I've got my toe, Running Shoe.
Me too, Running Shoe.
We'll never be able to finish the race now. What were you doing, Henry?
You were just about to win the race.
Winning is great, but it's not as important as helping your friends. We started this race together, and we'll finish it together.
We did it!
We made it across the line and finished the race.
Thanks, Henry.
You're welcome, Running Shoes. That's what friends are for.
Yay!
The day Henry met Running Shoes, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met Running Shoes, he made lots of friends and had so much fun.
Henry!
That's my mum calling me, Running Shoes. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all ours, wasn't it, Running Shoe?
It was, Running Shoe. And thanks for helping us compete in our first sporting event and win a medal.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a canvas.
Hello, canvas.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, Canvas?
I'm great, thanks, Henri. I'm so lucky to live in an art gallery and spend my days surrounded by some of the most amazing works of art in the world.
Wow, Canvas, there's so many.
Over here, we have some traditional oil paintings. A portrait, a landscape, and a still life.
Hello, Henry.
And over here, we have some examples of modern art. Abstract and pop art.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, everyone. Wow, that's so interesting, Canvas. I didn't know that there were so many different types of paintings. But, how come you're down here and not hanging on the wall with all of your friends?
Oh, just look at me, Henri. I'm completely blank. So dull, so lifeless, so devoid of color or artistic flair. I'd never be hung in an art gallery looking like this. Oh, if only there was an artiste around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Canvas. I could become an artist, and we can create a masterpiece together.
That's a great idea, Henri.
Okay, Canvas. First things first. We're going to need some paint.
Hello, Henry. I'm red.
I'm blue.
And I'm yellow.
And together we are...
The Primary Colours!
Primary colours? That sounds very important, Canvas.
It certainly is, Henri. By mixing these three, you can create lots of different colours.
If you mix red and yellow, you get...
orange.
If you mix yellow and blue, you get...
green.
And if you mix blue and red, you get...
purple.
That's great. Now we have lots of colours. I just need to decide what I'm going to paint.
How about a self-portrait, Henri?
A self-portrait? What's that, Canvas?
A self-portrait is when you paint a picture of yourself.
That sounds perfect, Canvas. Let's start painting. Hello, paintbrush.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, easel.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, pot of water.
Hello, Henry.
There you go, Canvas. All done. What do you think?
Wow, Henri. That's amazing. It's the best self-portrait I've ever seen. But it looks like it's missing something.
What's that then, Canvas?
A work of art like this needs a signature before it's finished. That way everyone will know who painted it. You should sign it, Henri.
Will do, Canvas. Will do.
Be careful, Henri.
Whoa! That was a close one, Canvas. Canvas? Oh, no! I'm so sorry. You're ruined.
Ruined? On the contrary, Henri. I think I look marvelous. Such color, such texture, such energy. I'm perfect. Your painting, it's a masterpiece.
A masterpiece? Do you really think so?
Most definitely, Henri.
Well, in that case, there's only one thing left to do. Just a little bit to the left. There. Perfect. What do you think, Canvas?
Oh, I feel fantastic, Henri. But aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, of course. I still have to sign you.
Yay!
The day Henry met a canvas, he laughed.
My mom calling me, Canvas. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henri. And thanks for helping me finally become a beautiful work of art.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henri.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mom.
The day Henry met
a horse.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, horse?
Oh, I feel positively spiffing, Henry, darling. I'm just relaxing here in the stables with my wonderful family.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, horses, family.
They're giving me lots of moral support as I prepare for the big equestrian games today.
Wow, that's great news, horse. But, What are the equestrian games?
The equestrian games are like a big, splendid sports event, Henry. They're especially designed for horses and their riders.
Oh, I love sports. My favourite is football.
My favourite is show jumping, Henry. I get to gallop around a special course with a show jumper on my back, jump over lots of different obstacles, and if I do it in the fastest time without knocking anything over, I win a rosette.
Hello.
That sounds so exciting, horse. I'd love to win a rosette.
Me too, Henry. And I've been practicing jolly hard, so as long as nothing goes wrong, I just might win one this time.
Horse, well, you're never going to believe what's happened.
What is it, Horsebox?
Your show jumper jumped out of the wrong side of the bed, hurt his toe, and he can't get his riding boots on.
Oh no, Henry. If only there was another show jumper around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Horse. I could become a show jumper, and we can enter the equestrian games and try and win a rosette together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, Horse, first things first. We're going to need a saddle,
yep.
A bridle, whoop, and a new set of clean horseshoes.
Excellent job, Henry. I'm all set. Oh, but aren't you forgetting something?
Of course, my riding helmet.
Oh, Henry, did you hear that? That's the starting bell.
Well, there's no time to waste. Giddy up, horse. Let's go. Hello, brush and rails.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, water jump.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, triple burrs.
Hello, Henry.
Jolly good show, Henry. One more jump like that, and we're certain to win a rosette.
What's the last obstacle?
I'm not quite sure, Henry, but as long as it's not a big, scary, tall wall, we'll be fine.
Whoa!
Oh, no, Henry. It is a big, scary, tall wall.
Oh, sorry.
I'm sure if we take a long run up, we just might make it over the wall safely.
Let's hope you're right, Henry. Tally-ho! Let's give it a go! I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm not going to do it, yay!
What's the matter, horse?
Oh, it's no use, Henry. The wall is too tall and I've lost my confidence. To be perfectly honest, I'd rather just go home to the stables and be with my family.
That gives me a great idea. Wait here, horse. I'll be back in no time. You don't have to go home to your family, because I've brought your family to you.
Good luck, horse. You can do it.
Oh, how splendid. That's given my confidence a jolly good boost. Hop on, Henry. I think I just might be able to jump over that wall after all.
Tally-ho, let's give it a go. Do it. You just needed a little support from your family.
The day Henry met a horse, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a horse, he made lots of friends and had so much fun.
Henry!
That's my mum calling me, horse. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for helping me complete the course and win my first ever rosette.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye, everyone. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a sponge.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, Sponge?
Oh, I'm great, thanks, Henry. You can't be cleaning windows. I just love soaking up the soapy water, splatting it onto the window and making it all sparkly clean. There, that's your whole house done, Henry. What do you think?
Wow, they look amazing, Sponge. And now that the whole house is finished, does that mean you and Bucket can take the rest of the day off?
Oh, we'd love to, Henry, dear.
But we still have a whole street of dirty windows to clean first.
Hello, Henry!
Hello, houses. That looks like a lot of hard work, Sponge. Can't you come back and do some of them tomorrow?
I'm afraid not, Henry dear.
Today is the day of the big street carnival, and all the windows must be extra clean so the street looks spick and span.
Hey, street carnival!
Oh, yay. I can't wait for the carnival. And it looks like everyone is really excited too. But how can you possibly get all the windows clean in time?
Don't worry, Henry. I have a window cleaner coming to help me. In fact, he should be here any moment.
Sponge, Bucky, I have some terrible news. The window cleaner's got stuck up a ladder and he won't be able to make it in time to help clean the windows.
Oh, no, Henry. What are we going to do? We'll never be able to get all the windows clean in time. Oh, if only there was another window cleaner around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Sponge. I can become a window cleaner and I can help clean all the windows in time for the big street carnival.
That's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, Bucket, I'm going to need you first. Ready?
Ready, Henry?
Next, we need some water.
Be my guest, Henry.
Thanks, Tap. And last but not least, we need lots of soapy bubbles.
Here you are, Henry.
Thanks.
Oh, careful now, boys and girls.
Bucket's right, water squirters. You must be careful when there's water about. You don't want to slip and hurt yourselves.
Sorry, Henry.
Okay, everyone. We're all set. Let's get these windows clean. Hello, living room.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, oven.
Hello, Henry, my little buttered scone.
Hello, king-sized bed.
Hello, Henry.
There, all done.
Wow, they're the cleanest windows I've ever seen.
All we have to do now is sit back and enjoy the street carnival.
Oh, wait, Henry dear, you don't want to stand there. There's a big puddle in the road, and if a truck goes by, you might get splashed. Oh, dear me. We're covered in mud. How horrible.
It's not just us, Bucket. The whole street is covered in mud.
All that hard work for nothing. What should we do now, Henry?
Got you.
Don't worry, Sponge. I think I have an idea. Okay. Everybody ready?
Ready.
Let's get cleaning!
Wow, we did it, Henry. All the windows are sparkling clean again. What an amazing job. Well done.
Thanks, Sponge. But I couldn't have done it without everyone's help. Now, who wants to watch the carnival?
Yay!
The day Henry met a sponge, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a sponge, he made lots of friends and had so much fun.
Henry!
That's my mum calling me, Sponge. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you and Bucket.
The pleasure was all ours, Henry. And thanks for helping us clean all those windows in time for the big street carnival.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met.
A Christmas tree.
Hello, Christmas tree.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, Christmas tree?
I'm so excited, Henry. I just love everything about Christmas. I love Christmas puddings, Christmas cards, and most of all, Christmas carols.
La, 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 la.
That was great, everyone.
Thanks, Henry.
My favorite thing about Christmas is giving my family and friends lots of Christmas presents. Oh, that reminds me, Christmas tree. What would you like for Christmas?
Well, there is one thing, Henry.
What's that, Christmas tree?
I've always wanted to be this special Christmas tree in the center of town. Oh, but nobody would like a tiny tree like me.
It doesn't matter how small you are. All that matters is that you have Christmas spirit. And Christmas tree, you have the most Christmas spirit ever.
Thanks, Henry. Maybe I could be the tiny Christmas tree. Oh, if only there was a Christmas elf around to help. Everyone knows how good elves are at decorating Christmas trees.
That gives me a great idea, Christmas tree. I could become a Christmas elf, and I could decorate you and get you ready to be the big attraction in the centre of town.
That's a great idea. But, Henry, where are we?
We're in my elf workshop at the North Pole.
Brr, it's a bit chilly.
I'm going to use all these magical elf gadgets and gizmos to make some super special extra Christmassy decorations.
That sounds wonderful, Henry.
Okay, magical elf gadgets and gizmos, let's go! Hello, candy canes.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, baubles.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, Star. Now all we have to do is go to the centre of town and decorate you.
Oh, how exciting, Henry! But how are we going to get there in time? We're miles away at the North Pole.
Don't worry, Christmas tree. Just follow me through this magical elf door. There's no time to waste, Christmas tree. Let's get decorating!
Decorations look amazing. All you need to do now is switch on the lights.
Will do, Christmas tree. Will do.
But wait, Henry. Something's not quite right. I feel like I'm missing something.
Oh, of course. You don't have a star. In all the excitement, I must have left it at the elf workshop.
Oh no, Henry. What are we going to do? You can't have a Christmas tree without something at the top.
Don't worry, Christmas tree. I think I have an idea. Hello? Can I speak to Father Christmas, please?
Everybody, look!
Thanks, Father Christmas.
You're welcome, Henry.
Okay, Henry. Time to turn the lights on.
3, 2, 1.
How do I look, Henry?
You look like the bestest Christmas tree ever!
Yay!
Oh, thanks, Henry! I finally got my Christmas wish. And it's all thanks to you. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Christmas tree! Merry Christmas, everyone!
The day Henry met a Christmas tree.
My mum calling me Christmas tree. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for helping grant my Christmas wish.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a wheelie bin.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, Wheelie Bin?
Oh, I'm great, thanks, Henry. Is that a bag of rubbish I smell?
It is, Wheelie Bin. Open wide.
Yum, 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 yum. Oh, that flavour. It's delicious. I'm getting subtle tones of greasy chicken bone. And, oh, the tiniest hint of mouldy cheese. Oh, excuse me. Anything else you need to put into the rubbish today, then, Henry?
I have these twigs, a plastic bottle, and an old newspaper.
Oh, you can't throw those in here. They can be recycled.
Recycled? What does that mean, Wheelie Bin?
Recycling is when things like glass, metal, and plastic are collected so they can be made into new things and don't end up just being thrown away.
Recycling sounds like a good idea.
Did someone say recycling?
No, oh, I love recycling, especially plastic bottles and newspapers.
I only eat garden waste, Henry. Things like grass or vegetable peels. So those twigs would go down a treat.
Well, in that case, help yourself.
Excuse me.
Okay, Bins. That's all the rubbish and recycling sorted. I'm sure the waste collector will be here any minute.
Wheelie Bin, Wheelie Bin, you're never going to believe what's happened. The waste collector has gone on holiday, so there's no one to empty all the bins.
Oh, what are we going to do, Henry? We can't sit out here in the sun all day. We'll start getting really smelly. Oh, if only there was another waste collector around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Wheelie Bin. I could become a waste collector, and I could help collect all the rubbish and recycling.
That's a great idea, Henry. Okay, when you're collecting rubbish, you need to be very careful. You need your boots, gloves, and high visibility jacket.
All present and correct, Wheelie Bin. Now, hop on board. We've got lots of bins to empty, and I need all the help I can get.
Fasten your seatbelt, and I'll take it from here.
Will do, Bin Lurry. Will do. Okay, everyone, let's go! Hello, House!
Hello, Henry!
Hello, Shop!
Hello, Henry!
Hello, School!
Hello, Henry!
Okay, Wheelie Bin, only one more house to go.
Oh, no, Henry! Look! There's rubbish everywhere!
Oh, I'm sorry, everyone. The wind must have blown over all my bins in the night. Oh, how embarrassing.
Don't worry, House. You've got Henry and his waste collecting team at your service. Banana skin, potato peels, apple core. You go in the compost bin.
Okay, Henry.
Tin can, plastic bottles, and cardboard box. Recycling bin, please.
Okay, Henry.
Polystyrene, bubble wrap, crisp packets. All in the black bin, please.
Okay, Henry!
There, that's all the rubbish collected and sorted. Well done, everyone.
Hold on a moment, Henry. There's still one piece of rubbish left. This old ceramic sink.
Oh, hello, sink. Which bin do you fit into? Maybe you should go in the compost bin.
Nope, not in here, Henry.
What about the recycling bin?
No, not in here, I'm afraid, Henry.
What about you, Wheelie Bin?
Sorry, not in here either, Henry.
Oh, no, it doesn't look like I belong in any of those bins, Henry. I guess I'll just have to stay out here in the garden.
Wait a moment, Sink. I think I have an idea. There. All done. You may be an old cracked sink, but you make a perfect planting trough.
Oh, thank you, Henry. Oh,
well done, Henry. You've collected all the rubbish, sorted all the recycling, and even brightened up the house's garden.
Thanks, Wheelie Bin. But I couldn't have done it without your help.
Yay!
The day Henry met a Wheelie Bin, he laughed along with everyone.
That's my mum calling me, Wheelie Bin. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for helping collect all the rubbish.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a bear.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, Bear?
I'm great, thank you, Henry, but I'm just so tired.
Why don't you just put your feet up, close your eyes, and have a lovely little snooze?
Oh, I would, Henry, but this park is so noisy. If it's not the woodpecker pecking, it's the babbling brook babbling.
Bubble, bubble, bubble.
At this rate, I won't be able to hibernate.
Hibernate? What does that mean, Bear?
Well, Henry, in the winter there isn't much food about, so some animals eat as much as they can and then go to sleep until spring. Then they wake up when it's warmer and there's more food around. And that's called hibernation.
But Bear, isn't it almost winter?
It is, Henry, and I should be getting ready to sleep. Oh, if only there was a park ranger around who could help me find a nice quiet spot to hibernate for the winter.
That gives me a great idea, Bear. I could become a park ranger and I could help you find a nice quiet place to hibernate in.
Oh, that's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, Bear, first things first. We need to find somewhere cozy and quiet. Oh, this seems lovely and peaceful, Bear. Why don't you make yourself comfortable inside this tree?
Good thinking, Henry.
Just close your eyes and relax. There you go. I'm sure nothing will wake you up.
Timber!
Ah! Ah!
Excuse me, coming through. Oh, dear, what a racket, Henry. I was falling into a really wonderful sleep.
Don't worry, Bear. I'm sure the beavers will be finished soon.
Right, no, Henry. We're going to be here all winter. We don't hibernate. Oh, no, Henry. Looks like I'll be awake all winter.
Don't worry, Bear. I'm sure if we keep looking, we're bound to find the perfect place. Oh, what about this burrow beside this peaceful stream?
Woohoo! Yippee!
Oh, no. All the salmon are going upstream. What about under this rocky ledge?
La 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 la!
Ah! Oh, looks like that eagle is practicing her singing.
This rock looks lovely and comfy, Bear.
Oh!
Oh no, Bear. It's a full moon and all the wolves are howling.
What are we going to do, Henry? It's getting dark and we still haven't found a place for me to hibernate in. Oh, things just couldn't get any worse. Oh.
Quick, Bear. We can shelter from the storm in that cave.
Jump, jump, everyone inside. Oh, looks like we're stuck in here until the storm ends, Henry. We're never going to find a place for me to hibernate.
Hold on a minute, Bear. I think we've just found the perfect place for you to sleep. This cave. It's warm, it's cozy, and most importantly, it's quiet.
You're right, Henry. I'll just get myself settled down here. Oh, Henry, I can't sleep. After all the excitement, I'm wide awake.
Don't worry, Bear. Whenever I'm wide awake, my dad tells me a bedtime story. Then before I know it, I'm sound asleep.
Oh, good thinking, Henry.
One day, Henry met a very sleepy bear. They couldn't find anywhere for him to sleep until they found a cozy, warm cave. Then Bear fell into a lovely, deep sleep.
The day Henry met a bear, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a bear, he made lots of friends and had so much fun. Henry!
That's my mum calling me, Bear. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. Thanks for finding me a place to hibernate.
You're welcome, Bear. Have a nice sleep.
Night-night, Henry.
Night-night, Bear.
The day Henry met
a camera.
Hello, camera.
Hello, Henry.
How are you today, camera?
I'm great, thanks, Henry. I just love taking photographs. Say cheese.
Cheese.
Perfect.
Camera, how do we get the photographs from you onto the paper?
Years ago, the only way was to get the photographs developed in a dark room with lots of stinky chemicals. But these days, we can print them off on a computer. Follow me and I'll show you how.
Hello, computer. Hello, printer.
Hello, Henry. Camera, do you have any of your lovely photographs for me to print today?
I certainly do, printer.
Well, hop over here, get yourself plugged in, and press print.
Printing!
Thanks, printer.
That photograph would look really nice on my wall, Henry.
Wow! It looks like you've taken photographs of everything in the entire world.
Not quite everything, Henry. I've always wanted to take a photograph of the Loch Ness Monster. But I'm worried I'd be so nervous I wouldn't be able to hold myself steady. Oh, if only there was a photographer around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Camera. I could become a photographer and we can take a photo of the Loch Ness Monster together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
Okay, Camera, first things first. Let's find the boat and head out onto the loch.
Heading out onto the loch, are you?
We certainly are. We're looking for the Loch Ness Monster.
I saw a monster once.
You did? When was that, boat?
It was a day much like today. An icy cold mist crawled across the loch, like a big, icy, cold, crawly thing. Completely alone I was, sat in the middle of the loch, bobbing up and down. I bobbed up, I bobbed down.
And then what happened, boat?
And then I bobbed back up again. Then a hideous creature reared up next to me.
Oh no!
I could smell its foul breath.
And then what, boat?
It opened up its cavernous mouth and said...
What did it say?
It said...
Yes?
Dinner's ready!
The Loch Ness Monster said, dinner's ready?
The Loch Ness Monster? Oh, sorry, Henry. I was talking about my tugboat over there. He gets awful cranky if I'm late for my dinner.
Cooey!
Hello, tugboat.
I've never actually seen the Loch Ness Monster, I'm afraid, but I'd love to help.
That's great news, boat.
I'm sure if we all work together, we'll find the Loch Ness Monster in no time. Let's go! Look over there, Camera. Could it be the Loch Ness Monster? Oh, maybe that's the Loch Ness Monster over there.
Excuse me, mysterious floating log coming through.
Camera, look! That has to be the Loch Ness Monster up there.
Sorry, Henry. Just old ruins of a castle, I'm afraid.
Oh, dear, Henry. We're never going to find the Loch Ness Monster at this rate.
Camera's right, Henry. With all this fog around, we wouldn't know a monster even if we rode straight into it.
Loch Ness Monster! Roar!
Quick, Camera! Now's your chance!
I can't, Henry. I'm shaking too much. I'll never be able to take a good picture.
Oh, did you just say you wanted to take my picture? Oh, I so rarely get my photo taken these days. For some reason, everybody seems to run away screaming when I loom up unexpectedly out of the water going, "Rawr!"
In that case, would you mind if Camera took your photograph?
Oh, that would be lovely, Henry dear. Just make sure you get my good side, okay?
Will do, Loch Ness Monster. Will do.
Okay, everyone. Say cheese.
Cheese.
The day Henry met a camera, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a camera, he made lots of friends and had so much fun.
Henry.
That's my mum calling me, Camera. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for helping me track down the Loch Ness Monster and taking the best picture ever.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye. I'm coming, Mum.
The day Henry met
a violin.
How are you today, Violin?
I'm so excited! It's the opening night of our big concert show, Henry! The fabulous orchestra and I will be playing the most beautiful classical music ever!
That sounds amazing, Violin! But what are you doing out here in the foyer? Shouldn't you be getting ready to perform?
Well, you see, Henry, I'm out here waiting for the conductor to arrive. The conductor has a very important job, Henry. He helps with the overall performance and keeps all the different instruments in time. So the drums know when to drum and the trumpets know when to trump.
Wow, that sounds like a tough job, Violin. But don't worry, I'm sure he'll be here in no time.
Violin, Violin.
Hello, Beau. What's the matter?
It's the conductor. It's so windy outside, a three-piece suit has blown off the washing line.
He's stuck at home in his underpants. What are we going to do now?
Oh no, this is a disaster. If only there was another conductor around to help.
That gives me a great idea, Violin. I could become a conductor, and I could conduct the orchestra, and we could put on the concert together.
That's a great idea, Henry.
I didn't realize there were so many different instruments in an orchestra.
It may look like a lot, but all the instruments are separated into four different groups, or as we like to call them, sections.
Can you introduce me to all of your friends then, please?
Of course, Henry. First up, we have the brass section.
Hi, Henry. I'm trumpet.
I'm trombone. And I'm tuba.
And here we have the woodwind section.
Hi, Henry. I'm clarinet. I'm flute. La, 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 la.
And I'm bassoon.
Next up is the percussion section.
Hello, Henry. I'm xylophone. La, 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 la,
la, la. I'm kettle drum. Bo, bo, bo,
bo, bo, bo. And I'm gong.
Last but not least, we have the string section.
Hi, Henry. I'm double bass. La, 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 la,
la. I'm cello. La, 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 la.
And don't forget me. This is where I belong. La, 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 la,
la. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Henry!
Okay, Violin. Let's get the concert started.
Henry, before we start, would you mind closing the window, please? It's awfully windy outside, and we don't want anything to blow away.
Will do, Violin. Will do. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I have the great pleasure of introducing the exciting first performance of Henry and his super-duper amazing orchestra. Places, please. Does everyone have their sheet music?
Ready, Henry!
Okay, here goes! Uh-oh!
Oh no, Henry! The wind has blown away all the sheet music! Without it, the instruments won't know what to play! This is a catastrophe!
Don't worry, Violin. I think I have an idea. Okay, follow my lead, everyone. You first, brass section. Ba da 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 da. Now woodwind and strings together. La 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 la. Okay, now everybody. Ba 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 ba.
We got a standing ovation.
You're welcome, Violin, but I couldn't have done it without your help. Okay, everyone, time for an encore.
The day Henry met a violin, he laughed along with everyone. The day Henry met a violin, he made us a friend and had so much fun.
Henry!
That's my mum calling me, Violin. I best be off. It was really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine, Henry. And thanks for performing with us.
You're welcome. Have a nice evening.
Bye-bye, Henry.
Bye-bye, Violin. I'm coming, Mum.